some ways, the whole message of the Bible can be understood as a movement from a garden to a city. And it's true that God loves cities. The thing is, this side of Jesus' return, cities are always full of people who have stuff and people who don't. But one of the things that we're committed to as a church is loving our city, loving Liverpool. And that means that we're going to work hard at encouraging people to be involved in the welfare of Liverpool. It doesn't mean we set up loads of new activities or loads of new groups. What it means is that we encourage people to help out with a City Mission Cafe. We encourage people to work with Refugee Action and things like that. And as a whole church, we pray for the well-being of Liverpool.
Here in Liverpool's Chinatown, there's all sorts of different kinds of people. And if you visit Liverpool's universities, you'll find that there are people from all sorts of countries in the world. But just because the world comes to Liverpool doesn't mean that we don't think as a church we've got a responsibility to go to the world as well. In fact, one of the things that we are really convinced about as a church is that we need to take the message about Jesus to the whole world.
We think it's really important for Christians to go to other places and tell people about Jesus Christ. And so for that reason, as a church, we encourage people to support evangelism projects overseas, and also projects that help people just to live better lives around the world. And we want to do that by encouraging people to come to our church to pray for the world, and to give money so that other people can take the message of Jesus to the world.
We want to encourage people to go and travel, to meet people from other cultures, and to take the message about Jesus and practical help and support, either short term or long term, to different places in God's earth.
Liverpool is a big place, and there are lots of people who live here, and it's obvious that one congregation in the centre of Liverpool can't reach the whole city with the good news of Jesus Christ, which is what we want to do. So as a church family, we've committed ourselves to be involved in church planting. That doesn't mean it's just a kind of add-on activity, something that we do every now and again. But church planting is right at the heart of what we think about and what we do together as a church. We're going to look to plant all sorts of different kinds of congregations, some bigger, some smaller, some looking at churches which are struggling, which we might be able to help out. Others planting into new areas altogether. We're involved in training leaders who are going to be able to lead those church plants, and others who are going to be able to go along and support the work.
These seven things that we've just been talking about are really held together by three overarching principles. They're not just three more things that we do, they're three things that we think shape the way we do all of the things that we're involved in as a church. The first one is that we want to be a missional church. That may be a word that's not familiar to some. Essentially what it means is that we don't think the mission field, the people who need to hear about Jesus, is just somewhere out there in some kind of heathen foreign lands. It's actually amongst the people that we live with, that we share our offices with and our homes with. They're people who need to know about the Lord Jesus and to believe in him. So we think that the church is there to help people show God's character to the world, starting with the places where he's put us. The second overarching principle is that we want to be a biblical church. Now, that doesn't just mean that we're going to teach the Bible in our meetings on a Sunday, though we certainly do try and do that. Rather, what it means is that we want the Bible to be the thing that shapes not just the things we do, but also the way that we do them. And the things that the Bible says about our values and our attitudes need to shape the way in which we go about the various tasks we do, both as we meet people who are not yet Christians, and as we deal with one another as a church family. The third overarching principle is that we want to be a prayerful church. One of our core convictions at Christ Church is that God is the great King. He's absolutely in charge of everything in the universe, and we can trust him to bring about what he wants in his world. And because of that, what we need most of all is God's grace and his kindness and his mercy. So for us to achieve the things that we want to achieve as a church, what we need is to ask God for him to bring them about, because he really cares about this city and about the people who live here.
hope you've enjoyed our DVD and it's helped you know a little bit more about what Christchurch is like and what we're trying to do. If you'd like to find out any more or you'd like to get in touch with us, then the addresses and contact details are coming up at the end of the DVD.
For my love is never ending, and you are my savior.